Good morning, everybody. I think most of us would have met me. Most of you would have met me. This is, about the natural birthing, which we are doing in Bloom Birthing Center. There are a few couple who have come here from outside who want to know more about the natural birthing and what exactly is natural birthing and what we exactly do in natural birthing. So this is a gist of what we do, just to have a knowledge and a little bit of enlightenment about the process. So what is natural birthing? It is not moving. Natural childbirth is a non-medicated approach to labor and birth. So, nariya perukku vanda, I'm going to use both Tamil and English because I'm more comfortable that way. So, natural birthing abdingarathukku, normal delivery abdingarathukku, enna difference? Everybody are doing a normal delivery. So, natural birthing and normal delivery abdingarathukku enna difference na? Normal delivery la, we use a lot of medication to, we might use a lot of medication to induce labor. Pain varathukku we might use. And sometimes pain adequate illa or the labor process is very slow, then probably we might add some medicines called oxytocin to augment the pain, that is to increase the pain intensity. So idella vandu it is in the modern obstetrics ingadhu after probably the past 60 years la vanda oru new concept of birthing and women or delivering and women. Why this modern obstetrics ingra oru field it came upon na, there were a lot of mothers were like having maternal deaths due to unassisted births in the ancient world or the previous two decades back. Nariya maternal deaths were happening because oru knowledge illa and there were certain complications which went unidentified. So idella vandu nama overcome pananum. We are not supposed to lose a mother during a labor process or during a delivery process. Abdingadla, we started as doctors. The Indian Association or the Royal College of UK or the ACOG, that is American College of Obstetrics and Gynecology, ellaru vandu they came up to this concept of modern obstetrics. Modern obstetrics, the main aim is to not to lose a mother. So not to lose a mother abdingra and the concept la, we lost how a woman supposed to birth. The natural process abdingaradhu marandu poichu because we were more conscious. See, we were losing a mother 1 in 1,000. So by chance enna aichuna, all the 1,000 women were not allowed for a natural birthing. So careful la paakano, nothing should go wrong abdin and the or carefulness and meticulous monitoring idella vandu jaasi arappa enna aichuna, the rate of C-sections increased and even the awareness to the general population, like general women, the fear towards a normal delivery, a fear towards a birthing, okay, edadu complication vandrumo, edadu naayidumo, abdingana, and the fear even for the general population, and even towards, for us as a medical student, when we are doing an obstetric training in our college days, we were like told to monitor the patient very carefully because something might go wrong or something should not go wrong. This was what was induced into our mind. So this, I won't say that was wrong, but eventually what happened, we started ending up, even for a smallest issue, we started doing a C-section. So chinna chinna vishayam, chinna chinna change from a normal pathway, we started doing a C-section. And that is how our C-section rates have increased all over the world. It's not in India. It is not a problem in India or Tamil Nadu, but it became an issue all over the world. Inniki poite, if we talk to a person in America, a gynecologist, their problem is to reduce their C-section. They, one of their goals for the next 5 years is to reduce their C-section rate, but at the same time, they're not supposed to increase their maternal mortality rate. So this is a problem worldwide. So it is not a problem just in India or just in Tamil Nadu. Like, even I was a part of this Vijay TV Niyan and our show and all to talk about natural, why this C-section rate is high and why normal delivery rate is coming down. So this is a concept which came into my mind. It's not just a concept. I was just, it is my own thought. Like, I was wondering why the C-section rate is going higher. Why are we missing our traditional? Aprina, my grandmother delivered in a natural way, her mother delivered in a natural way, and everything happened so naturally and easily. And why nowadays we are so scared of having a birthing and delivery, and why can't we do something combined? I'm not saying you have to go back to your traditional route and don't monitor everything, let everything happen easily or naturally. I'm not saying that. But why can't we combine both the traditional way, eppadi nama irundhom abdingaradhiyum, how a medicine can monitor that to an extent so that if there is a deviation, can we identify it earlier and we are also there to support it. At the same time, we should give a full support to that woman to deliver naturally. So this was what my thought was, can I do this? So that is when I met Jayashree, and she's a lactation consultant. She is a physiotherapist. So then we had a talk and we thought, okay, why can't we both work together? And because we both have the same kind of intention, she wanted a gynecologist support, and I needed a team support, because when I say natural birthing, the gynecologist cannot sit, because I have to allow that patient to take her own time, like 48 hours analum. I have to allow that woman. It can be more than 48 hours, but that doesn't mean I can spend the 48 hours entirely with the woman, because that is not possible as a doctor. Any human being, as a woman who has got children, who's got a family, cannot sit with one person for 48 hours. So I needed a team to do this. And this team should have the same intention, same goal, same kind of compassion towards the patient, same kind of care should be given. What I will do, the same thing has to be done by my team also. What I will think, the same thing should be done by my team as well. So this was how our team of Bloom Birthing started. And initially, I started with doing simple antenatal exercises, but it didn't work because it didn't really motivate women, like doing just antenatal exercises. So many doubts they had. And then we started this antenatal classes in the hospital itself. And after which, there's a tremendous improvement and tremendous knowledge being shared with patients, and I've also learned a lot from my patients. I should accept that, because there are some patients who will come and ask a particular doubt which I've never thought of. So then I have to go and read about it and understand, okay, there is something like this and I have to answer them. So even I've learned through my patients, especially something called lotus birthing, which I don't know at all. So when one couple came with so much of anxiety and they wanted a lotus birth, I said, what is lotus birth? They said, this is how Lord Krishna delivered, and I want my baby to be delivered by like Lord Krishna, because this is something which is, it's not a role of a job of a doctor to deliver a baby like how Lord Krishna was delivered. So, but then I can't say no to them, because I have this thing that I should give whatever the best I can do for the patient. So I spoke to Jayashree, and she said, yes, there's something called lotus birth, and this is what we do. And we did that to the patient, and she delivered the same way. And finally, all she did was, I bless you. she said, she literally came to my hospital at 38th week of her pregnancy in labor. She had pain, but she was not refusing to come into the hospital because no one was willing to do this lotus birth. And I thought, okay, fine, this is not going to harm the baby, or it is not going to harm the mother. Why don't we give a try with that? So then we did it, and finally she blessed. And then only I realized, oh my God, that is something so important for that couple. Maybe I don't know, but it is so important for that couple. So I thought, let me do something like that also, where people want something different, let me give them. But at the same time, with the care, so that I'm not supposed to do anything wrong, I should be able to identify when the deviation happens. So natural birthing is that. So holistic approach considers all aspects of an individual, including body, mind, and spirit. This is something which is new for me also. All these things about holistic birthing, I learned from a midwife who came from UK, and also from a midwife who came from US. It was again an accidental meeting. They came to Bloom and they trained us. and only that time I enna engla portha varaikku it's all medicine. You come, I'll check you, I'll do a blood test. If there is something wrong, I'll know how to treat you. That avladha engal theriyum. But there's nothing called mind or spirit to us. So from that I learned, okay, the birthings, there are people who consider this birthing as a very important thing in their life, or a very important occasion in their life, or what exactly they said was, it is something to do with the soul. So in the madrila concept is not into medicine, because we are not soul talking people. We are only talking straight to your face. So which was very new to me, but I was ready to learn from them. So a holistic pregnancy and childbirth recognize the impact of the mind and spirit as well as the physical body on the experience of pregnancy and birth, physical health, values and beliefs, relationships, emotional well-being and spirituality, and all affect pregnancy and birth. In turn, the experiences of pregnancy and birth influences body, mind and spirit. So again, I'm going back to British, in the Britain. When the modern obstetrics, okay, I'll take some time. When the modern obstetrics was very much in Britain, how they went back to natural birthing was, there was a lot of divorces happening in the family. Many women were not willing to give birth. It still happens in Western world, right? Many are not willing to have a pregnancy. Many are not willing to have a birthing. Or many, there's still divorces happening a lot. So the concept of birthing and giving them an idea that the birthing is not very tough. Bearing a child is not very tough. And when you have a birthing happening with your husband, it increases the bond between the husband and wife. So this is how the natural birthing is being imparted in the other Western world. And I'm seeing that with my patients. When the husband is let inside the labor room, and when the wife delivers, I see most of the husband crying. And this is something which is very, even for us, no, it is very taking us. Like, I feel somehow we are creating a family rather than giving birth to a child. So that is an increasing the bonding between the husband and wife, and they look at the child as an achievement by themselves. Giving birth is a achievement by both the husband and wife. They put the effort together. So even in their future, the husband will have that thing that he had helped the wife so much, and how much the wife had suffered or had to take that pain to deliver the baby. So this will help in their future as well. So a holistic birthing trusts the natural progression. A holistic approach to pregnancy and childbirth also recognizes that the woman's body is naturally designed to conceive, nourish, and give birth to the baby. So it is naturally designed. You need not do anything artificial to deliver a baby. Starts with least invasive approach, but uses the full range of therapy if needed. So we are not using any invasive things, no medicines for the onset of labor or birthing. But if there is a deviation, we are ready to use whatever is available to save that mother or save the baby. So that is also being given. So that is a holistic approach. That is natural as well as the medical. So it incorporates the integrative therapies. We are using the natural process. We are using the Ayurvedic therapies. We are using Ayurvedic massages. And we are also adding the medicine. So how does the holistic approach help you have the healthiest pregnancy possible, achieve the best possible overall well-being during pregnancy, increase your chances for a natural progression of labor, alleviate the risks passed by pain medications and medical intervention? So you're not getting into any risk of the fear of getting exposed to too many medications or medical interventions, and probably you will enjoy your birthing experience. So tradition of India, so coming back to what happened in India, whether this natural birthing is something which is very new for us, whether this is the first time we are doing this, no. This is something which has been happening hundreds and hundreds of years ago, which we have lost in the past 60 years. So we are trying to bring back those things with the careful monitoring. That is the only thing we are trying to do. So if you look at the ancient way of birthing, So I think this is a full squat birthing, which is a sculpture in temples. It is not something which I have taken. It's a sculpture in temples. It's a full squat birthing by a pregnant mother. This is a Mughal period where the woman is with squat with a back support. And this is a standing. This is a picture where the woman is birthing while she's standing. So these are all the birthing which was happening in the ancient world, which were forgotten recently, and we've gone to one particular type of position that is called the lithotomy, we say, where the woman is on the back with the foot wide separated, and we deliver the mother. This is the only thing which is provided now, but which might be very comfortable. It is not a comfortable position for many people. So each body is different. Each individual is different. Maybe you're comfortable sitting. Maybe I'm comfortable standing. Maybe I'm comfortable leaning back. Maybe you're comfortable leaning forward, where you can give more pressure to the pelvis. So this is what we are doing in Bloom, where we are allowing the mother to take any position they want. So the uncomfortable thing is to the doctor. Because any position, if you're squatting, then it's difficult for us to see what is happening with the baby. So that risk, that uncomfortable thing, we take up and we give the comfort to you. So Bloom Birthing Center, the core team, we have gynecologists available 24/7, pediatricians available 24/7. And childbirth educator we do have, and trained duty medical officers who've been helping me with the deliveries for the past 7 years. They're still with me, so they know. They're even better than me at identifying risk. And nursing midwives who are also with me for the past 5 years. They're not new people. They don't change frequently. They stay with us. So this is a team of gynecologists. We do have a male gynecologist, but doesn't come for the deliveries. Team of pediatrician. This was an old team. Now we have Dr. Balakumaran, who is a new addition. Jayashree, the childbirth educator, and the team of nurses and the midwives. So how the evolution of natural birthing started in Bloom, I think I spoke everything about it earlier itself, so I'm not going back to it. What are different modes of delivery? So natural birthing has got so many different things. So what are the other thing? The natural birth, water birth, Mary Morgan, hypnobirth, VBAC. VBAC is previous C-section, and you come for the second pregnancy for a normal bed delivery again. A childbirth educational classes, pregnancy aquanatal classes, and specialized pelvic and prenatal massages, and pregnancy foot reflexologies. All these are available, but not everybody take up everything. There are each individual take each one by their choice. Nothing is forced upon them. So difference between a normal delivery and natural delivery, I think I spoke about it. So is there, can I provide this natural birthing and water birthing to whomever walks into my consultation room? Can I do that? I cannot do that. I do have my own inclusion criteria and exclusion criteria, because I have to be careful, because I am not supposed to give a natural birthing to a person who's got a high blood pressure, very high alarming blood pressure, and a very high blood sugar, who's already has a risk with the baby. I am not supposed to give a natural birthing, because here the natural birthing is sometimes timeless. You have to wait for 48 hours. We waited for 56 hours and all. So in the madri time kudukada, I cannot do with the person who's already having a complicated birthing. Am I right in giving this to an IVF pregnancy, because they've conceived through IVF? Can I do this? Yes, I do this, because there are some of my IVF patients, a very young couple, and sometimes they have a problem with the husband, not the wife. Wife is perfectly all right. So I think I can give this option to say, conceive anadha, artificial conceive ananga, let them birth the child naturally. This is what my concept is. So I do allow natural birthing with my IVF patients, and many have gone through it also. And So two inclusion criteria is any pregnant woman can take it, should not have previous major medical complications, should not have an uncontrolled blood pressure during pregnancy or uncontrolled diabetes, should have undergone a previous C-section, just a gap of 2 years is, I'm more comfortable. If your previous child is, you've delivered through C-section 2 years, gap is there, then I'm comfortable in delivering your second child through vaginal delivery. But if it is lesser gap, then I need a proper monitoring during the delivery. Should not have any major viral infection in the vaginal area. I've had a patient who had a major viral infection in the vaginal area, which can affect the baby if I'm delivering through vaginal route. So I couldn't really offer her. So antenatal preparations, what we do, we guide towards the right food, psychological support. I think people who talk to me, most of the time I talk about food only. To eat this. So most of the time in the consultation, I talk about food and physical activity and psychological support, physical exercise classes, labor exercises, birthing positions we teach them, and labor support. Most important, the medical support and follow-up is also being done. It is not just talking. So coming to birth positions, I'm just going to show some of the pictures where the birth positions, what different birth positions are available. So this is squatting. I think people who are going for the antenatal classes will know this is how you have to do the squats. And this is sitting on a birth ball and doing exercise. So birth ball and squatting, what does that do to your body? It opens up your pelvis. It widens up your pelvis. It relaxes your pelvic muscle. So when your pelvis opens up, the baby or a thala keela erangardhi, it happens naturally. Sometimes, ipala vandu thalaye erangla. பெயினே வரலங்கிறதா நிறைய பேர் சி செக்ஷன் போகிறது. ஸோ இந்த தலை நல்லா ஈஸியாக இறங்கணும்னா வாட் யூ ஆர் சப்போஸ் டு டூ? யூ ஆர் சப்போஸ் டு டூ சம் எக்ஸசைசஸ் டு யுவர் பெல்விக் போன்ஸ். ஸோ வைடனிங் அப் யுவர் பெல்விஸ் இஸ் எஸ்பெஷலி த பெல்விக் அவுட்லெட் இஸ் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட், இன்லெட் அண்ட் அவுட்லெட் அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவோம் மெடிக்கலி. ஸோ தட் இஸ் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் அண்ட் தட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் ஒன்லி வென் யூ டூ அ ப்ராப்பர் ஸ்குவாட்ஸ், த ஜிம் பால் எக்ஸசைசஸ் அண்ட் ஸோ ஆன். இது பண்ண தெரியாதவங்க, நான் வீட்டில் நிறைய பேருக்கு சொல்லியிருப்பேன், உட்காந்து தர தொடங்க, மாப் த ஃப்ளோர், ஸ்குவாட் அண்ட் மாப் த ஃப்ளோர் இன் அ வே யூர் ஹெல்ப் டூயிங் அ ஹவுஸ் ஹோல்ட் ஒர்க். அட் த சேம் டைம் யூஆர் டூயிங் சம்திங் டு யுவர் பெல்விக் போன்ஸ். ப்ரூமிங் த ஹவுஸ், ஸ்குவாட்டிங் அண்ட் மாப்பிங் த ஃப்ளோர், தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் சம் எக்ஸசைசஸ் விச் தே வேர் டூயிங் அவர் பேரண்ட்ஸ், அவர் கிராண்ட் மதர்ஸ் வேர் டூயிங் விச் வியர் நாட் டூயிங். தீஸ் ஆர் சம்திங் விச் கேன் ஹெல்ப் தி நார்மல் அண்ட் நேச்சுரல் பர்திங். Again, these are all leaning on a birth ball, leaning over a bed on a birth ball. These are all different things which we help during your hospital stay. These are all some exercises which being taught in your the lunges, which can again open up your pelvic outlet. This is a bean ball where again you can squat and deliver. This helps you with the squatting position and delivering. And the rope which is hung from the ceiling, this is for the support. If you want to give a full squat, you need some support. So this rope is, or the cloth rope is for the support. So all this is taught during the antenatal period. So உங்களுக்கு லேபர் ரூம் போகிறப்ப நீங்கள் என்ன பண்ணணும் அப்படிங்கிறது உங்களுக்கு முன்னாடியே தெரியும். இட்ஸ் நாட் சம்திங் வெரி, லேபர் ரூம் இஸ் நாட் அ நைட் மேர், லேபர் ரூம் இஸ் நாட் சம்திங் வேர் யூ டோன்ட் நோ வாட் டு டூ, அந்த மாதிரி இருக்காது. யூ வில் நோ எவ்ரி திங் வாட் யூ ஆர் சப்போஸ் டு டூ. அண்ட் மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் த பேஷன்ஸ், மேம் ஐ டிட் திஸ் ப்ரீதிங் எக்ஸசைஸ் நவ் இட்ஸ் ஹெல்பிங் மீ, அந்த மாதிரி சொல்கிறவங்க நிறைய பேர் இருக்காங்க. ஐ திஸ் இஸ் வாட் ஐ லேர்ன் நவ் ஐம் டூயிங் இட். ஸோ இட் இஸ் நாட் சம்திங் விச் இஸ் டோட்டலி அன்னோன் ஃபார் யூ. So coming to Cochrane, Cochrane is our Bible. The obstetricians or any medical person, for us the Cochrane is a Bible. Cochrane அப்படிங்கிறது, what they say in Cochrane is what we are supposed to follow. அவங்க வந்து இது சரியில்லைன்னு சொன்னால் அது சரியில்லை, தட் இஸ் வாட் த என்டையர் வேர்ல்ட் வில் டூ. ஸோ வாட் தே சஜஸ்ட், அப்ரைட் பொசிஷன்ஸ் இன் வாக்கிங் இன் லேபர் ரூம் ஆர் அசோசியேட்டட் வித் ரிடக்ஷன் இன் த லென்த் ஆஃப் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டேஜ் ஆஃப் லேபர் அண்ட் யூஸ் ஆஃப் எபிடியூரல் அனால்ஜீசியா இஸ் அவாய்டட் பை டூயிங் சச் எக்ஸசைசஸ் வாக்கிங் அண்ட் யூசிங் அப்ரைட் பொசிஷன்ஸ் டியூரிங் த டெலிவரி. இட் ரெடியூசஸ் ஆல் தோஸ் திங்ஸ். ஸோ இட் இஸ் நாட் சம்திங் விச் இஸ் அகேன்ஸ்ட் மெடிசன், இட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அப்ரூவ்ட் பை அவர் மெடிக்கல் பைபிள். ஸோ come to bloom, see your dream blooming into reality. It happens with many people here.